Hey everybody, Brian here, and as we dig deeper with our exploration of this particular region, we're going to start with a country which many people probably first think of when they hear the term Latin America. What country is that? Why, it's Mexico, the home of some of the most advanced civilizations in the Western Hemisphere, a crown jewel of the former Spanish Empire, a unique example of Latin American democracy, a key trading partner for Canada, the United States, Central and South America, and a destination for tourists from around the world. However, as you've hopefully picked up on by now, there's so much more to Mexico than the beaches, so let's start with the unique topography and geography of Mexico. Part 1. Where is Mexico? I know, for many of us, Mexico is pretty easy to find on a map. However, simple location isn't always the only answer to where a place is, and so for that, we're going to turn to our trusty region types to find a better answer. Mexico. Formal region. Now, this may come as a surprise to many of you, but Mexico is formally located in the continent of North America. That's right, the physical features, which we'll talk about in a little while, and the general connection between Mexico and the rest of the North American landmass makes it an inseparable part of North America. So, why is that so surprising? Mexico, perceptual region. Well, it's most likely surprising because many people's perceptions, which is what perceptual regions are all about, connect Mexico to Central and South America. Culturally speaking, Mexico does share quite a bit with its neighbors to the south. With a largely Spanish-speaking population, but with multiple native languages still utilized, an historical connection over being a former Spanish colony, a long history of trade, and a shared determination to chart its own path, just as with other Latin American countries, which gained independence via revolution through the early and middle 19th century. Mexico has long been identified and identified itself as a proud member of the Latin American community. Mexico, functional region. Functionally, or as a region defined by connections, Mexico is really both? As a member of the USMCA, or United States-Mexico-Canada Agreement, Mexico is a deeply connected economic partner with the nations to the north. As a member of the Central American Free Trade Agreement, and with trade partnerships which span half of South America as well, Mexico is the linchpin for trade stretching from Tierra del Fuego to Nunavut. Part 2. Rivers. Let's begin our discussion of Mexico's physical features with a look at Mexico's waterways. Some you'll recognize, and some you might not. Now, unlike previous conversations we've had about rivers being important transportation highways, that's not always the case in Mexico. The many mountain ranges, which we'll discuss in another lesson, make many of the rivers of Mexico unnavigable. But rivers aren't only important because of boats. Rio Bravo del Norte. You may be thinking to yourself, wait a minute, you said I'd recognize some of these. I've never heard of the Rio Bravo del Norte before. Well, actually, you probably have, but just as with many physical features around the world, you probably know it by another name. In this case, its United States given name, the Rio Grande. Rio Bravo del Norte means angry northern river, and while it may occasionally be angry, it's also been a source of water and more recently a source of hydroelectric power for northern Mexico and the southern United States. With 21 dams or power generating stoppages on the river and providing power for 13 million along the U.S.-Mexico border, this essential river has been seeing water flow and thus power generation diminish over the last 20 years due to a changing climate. Rio Colorado. While only flowing about 112 miles through Mexico, the Rio Colorado, or Colorado River, has been a source of farming irrigation in the dry northwestern part of Mexico for a century or more. Heavy water usage on the U.S. side of the border, coupled with a changing climate, have drastically reduced the flow over the last 40 years. Rio Usumacinta. Running along the border between the Mexican state of Chiapas and the country of Guatemala, the Usumacinta is a waterway rich with ancient artifacts and biodiversity. Recently, it has been a source of controversy as this river is a source of transportation for refugees from Guatemala as they attempt to make their way into Mexico or beyond into the United States. Rio Conchos. The longest river which flows only within Mexico, the largest tributary of the Rio Bravo del Norte, and arguably the most important in Mexico, is the Rio Conchos, or Conchos River. Just as with the Rio Bravo, the Conchos is heavily used for hydroelectric power in Mexico, in addition to several reservoirs making it an important source of water for northern Mexico. The Conchos flows from its headwaters in the Sierra Madre Occidental, 559 miles to meet up with the Rio Grande in Ojinaga, in the Mexican state of Chihuahua. As always, we've only scratched the surface of Mexico's physical characteristics, but hopefully it will give you a good mental idea of the country itself. In another lesson, we'll delve deeper into Mexico's mountains, plateaus, and volcanoes. Until then, keep exploring. Hey!